Welcome to Show and Tell with the Two Mortgage Guys. We come to you live every Tuesday on Facebook, YouTube, LinkedIn, and Twitter. Today, we want to welcome Jeremy Goldsmith from BMO Harris. He's going to be with us today talking about credit. Stick around.
Jeremy Goldsmith is a financial wellness specialist at BMO Harris Bank in Indianapolis. He's been with BMO for almost 12 years. As a banker, he feels he's been fortunate to be put in a position to truly change people's lives. His passion is to provide the education behind what BMO offers. Most banks have similar products, but by demystifying these products, they then become solutions that change lives. When he's not working, he's spending his time with his girlfriend, Katie, his Goldendoodle Max, and the amazing network of friends and family in his life. He enjoys traveling, skiing, cooking, and the outdoors. Welcome to our show today, Jeremy.
Hey, welcome. Thank you.
Thanks for having me.
Good to have you.
It's always nice to come across somebody else who understands the importance of credit and can, you know, help educate and provide people advice on it, because not enough people out there do that.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Yeah, it's vital. I mean, it's... You know, I think about credit like your health. You know, if you're financially sound, life's a lot easier. You know, when you're in good shape, sometimes it's hard to get there, but it's easy to maintain once you know what you're doing.
It is, and you're right. And that's the same philosophy like Ryan and I have looked at for years working together, is not just getting their credit where they need to get a mortgage, but trying to help their credit so it builds it, like you said, more for their life.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely.
And, you know, I'm sure you've probably said this before too, but it's just really a shame they don't spend more time in school, really educating kids kind of out of the gates as far as what it means to have credit, how much it can impact your whole life, you know, and things to do and not do to kind of goof it up. And I feel like that's what happens a lot of times. People don't even realize what they're doing. They just kind of suddenly they've got something on a credit report, and maybe it's good, maybe it's bad, and it can be a challenge moving forward. So, you know, why is it important? Why is it important to establish and understand your credit?
Yeah, I mean, you're right. It's unfortunate we're not taught about credit. I wasn't taught about credit in high school. You know, I wasn't taught about credit in college. I was fortunate to be added as an authorized user. My dad was smart enough not to give me that credit card that he put me on. but, you know, just by having my name on there, it helped me start to establish it. So, I mean, credit is, I think, the foundation to everything financial. You know, you turn 18, and before you even understand what credit is or that it exists, you could devastate it in a second, and then you're digging yourself out of the trenches. So, you know, credit from a lending and a bank standpoint is basically viewed as one's ability to repay a debt. So, you know, it's a three-digit score that is kind of like, you know, like a report card, you know, if we're going to tie back to school a little bit there. But, you know, the stronger your credit, the easier life is, the easier, you know, it is to get that auto loan. If you're, you know, in forbidden accident, you're going to get a better rate the stronger your credit is, which is going to save you interest that you could put into an emergency fund or contribute to your retirement. So it's all encompassing, and it really does have a ripple effect throughout everything from a financial standpoint.
Agreed, 100%. So that's it. When you're doing that, so like, there's different philosophies when you get somebody. So you take somebody, Jeremy, sort of walk us through, like, since we know where we want to be at with that, some of the people that Ryan and I see, and you probably see too, that come in that either have no credit or low credit, some of the tips you give them and timing. There's a lot of it, I think, is how long it takes.
Yeah. So, you know, we can look at it from two different perspectives. First, if you've got somebody who has no established credit, you know, a clean slate is easier to work with than somebody who may have had some credit and then, you know, had some derogatory remarks, you know, that being a collection, a lien, you know, a judgment. But from the first perspective, if you've got no credit, you know, it's not hard to establish credit. It takes a little bit of time. But one of the things that I love that BMO offers is actually called a credit builder loan. And there are two different types of credit. There's an installment piece and there's a revolving piece, right? And I know you guys know this. The installment piece is that termed loan. So your auto loan, your mortgage, the credit builder loan, where you've got a set number of payments. And when you're done, that loan is done and there's no more debt to be repaid. Then you've got the revolving piece, which is that credit card. You know, you can open it when you're 18. You could move on to the next life at 80 and have had it from start to finish. And so we kind of think of it as a revolving door that just kind of keeps swinging around. So working, having those two things work in tandem is really where you start to establish strong credit. So, you know, I always recommend, depending on the person I'm working with, you know, not necessarily to jump right into a secured credit card, but more to start organically with a termed loan, such as a credit builder loan that BMO offers. You know, we take $1,000 of our money, we put it into an account in, you know, say Steve's name. Steve, you can't touch that money, but every month you make a payment about $45 and it goes towards that $1,000 loan that we've funded for you. After about 6 months, you go from no credit score to about a 650 to 680, give or take. So right off the bat, no credit, 6 months later, 650 to 680. And that's when we get back with you and work towards understanding how to properly use a credit card and kind of pair those two together, because you can only go so far with one piece, you know, one trade line. You need a nice mix of credit. And so those two working in tandem, the credit card, the credit builder, after a year, our clients are in the 700s. It's just making sure that they're still, you know, they're making their payments on time. They're keeping that utilization down on that credit card to 30% or less. So you got a $1,000 limit. You don't want to be using more than $300 at a time. And some tricks I recommend is, you know, pay your credit card once a week. You know, you're never going to miss a payment. Right. Whenever it does report to the credit bureaus once a month, you know, the utilization is going to be down and it's going to help you budget throughout the month instead of getting that big bill and realizing you spent more than you had.
All right. Cause they'll take your money for credit cards. Yeah. No matter what the amount is, you want to pay it. Yeah. So yeah, that's great.
Slick. So yeah. You've got people that they don't know where to start. And if they go online and apply for certain credit cards or they go to their bank and they try to just get a traditional loan with no established credit, they might get turned down. So with this program, I mean, it's designed for this. There's no risk for you guys, right? Because you're not letting them access the money till what? It's paid off. Is that how it works? They get access to the funds.
Correct. You got it. Yep. So once they make that 24th payment, they get that $1,000. So it's basically a forced savings account that helps them build their credit. You know, the bank makes give or take, don't quote me dollar exact, but about $5 a month over 2 years, about $120 to establish strong credit the right way. Like you said, you go into a bank and you apply for a credit card without credit, odds are you're going to be declined, or, you know, an auto loan, what have you. So starting early, getting it, having the knowledge behind it, not just jumping into it is crucial.
And like you said earlier, it's the credit utilization. It's also the on-time payment history, like you were talking about. The longer you have that, the better your score is going to be. So hence that 24-month $1,000 loan. If you do that whole time, you're going to have $1,000 extra in savings and 700 credit scores in that two-year period, which is awesome.
Nailed it. Yep.
So a lot of times people are confused as to what's actually reporting on a credit bureau. You know, they know they're paying utilities or their Netflix bill, things like that, but they don't really understand that not everything goes to a bureau. So that's important too, right? Because sometimes people think they can go their whole life without borrowing money. They want to do the right thing. Like they want to always pay cash for stuff, but we know how it works, man. At some point, something's going to happen and you're likely going to need to borrow money and you're going to need that credit. So I like that program. We've referred clients to that. You guys have had that for a long time. We referred clients to that over the years, but it's the first I've really had anybody totally explain it to me in that way, as far as like the time frame to establish your score. So you guys are consistently seeing like that 650 in 6 months or so.
Yep. You got it. And I started talking about the second piece, which is, you know, if you've already established credit, but maybe in the negative, on the negative side, you know, it wouldn't be to jump right into doing the credit builder or the credit card. It would be, you know, clearing some things up before taking that step. So sorry to go on a tangent there, but I did realize I never followed through with the second piece of that earlier.
Well, exactly, because that was sort of two pieces when I first started. That was the person with no credit, which is this person that you're saying within 6 to 12 months is going to be in pretty decent shape. But that person that's, you know, life happens, like Ryan said before, whatever, college student, late payments, divorce, loss of job. And then if you got whatever, medical collections, maybe a car repo or a charge off, that's where you've got a different route you guys start working down, correct?
Yes, yeah, certainly. Yep. So, you know, when you think about, so credit has, you know, there are six factors that go into determining credit. In order of importance, it's payment history, it's utilization, and that's overall your total limits versus your total utilization, but also your individual card level. So your credit cards, if you're maxing one card out, but you're great overall in utilization, it's still going to hurt your credit. The third most important are those derogatory remarks that you're talking about, Steve. And that, you know, and if you've got derogatory remarks, anything else that you're messing with your credit, those derogatories are going to act like an anchor, and they're going to keep you, you know, they're going to keep you down. Basically, they're going to keep you from making progress. So that's the most important piece, is to clean up the late payments, the derogatories, because, you know, the payment history, the utilization, the average age of your credit history, your total accounts, and your inquiries are not going to matter if you're not taking care of the piece that's really weighing heavily.
And I know this is different for everybody. You know, it depends on your situation. But if somebody comes to you, they're seeking some type of financing, and their credit's not the greatest. Let's say they're in the mid 500s. Okay, they've probably had a collection, or they've had something negative, late payments, whatever. You know, what's the quickest path you've seen to help that person kind of, you know, get a good foundation laid moving forward?
Yeah, that's a great question. It's biting the bullet, you know. You know, for instance, I can't tell you how many times I've sat down with somebody and you know, they forgot to return their cable equipment. I don't know if you guys, it's a common thing, right? Well, they didn't ask for it. Well, it wasn't yours, but you gotta bring it back. And if you don't, it's gonna show up on your credit bureaus as a collection. And so you know, I've sat down with dozens of people who say, I'm not paying that out of principal. Like, you know, they didn't ask for that back. And I say, okay, you know, I understand that's frustrating. However, out of principle, you're doing yourself far more damage, and you're giving the banks and the lenders far more money than you should be, because you don't want to bite the bullet and say, you know what, it is what it is. Let's move beyond it. I'll shell out $300. So, you know, the most important pieces when trying to clean up credit are just being humble, right? Reaching out to the collection agencies. You know, I've done this for years when I was a branch manager in Broderpool, was, you know, call on behalf of the client with them there with me, to say, hey, you know, my name's Jeremy. I'm with BMO. I'm calling with, you know, Steve, sorry to keep using you as an example, Steve. And, you know, we understand Steve might have a collection held by your company. We just want to get some information. The key pieces, though, are, one, if you can negotiate it down, that's fantastic. But more important than negotiating it is, you need it to be reflected as paid in full. If it reflects as settled, it's going to be way more difficult to get it off the report. So, you know, it's not a good trade-off to pay less than what's owed if it's going to show as settled. If they're willing to accept less and it's going to report as paid in full, fantastic. But the most important piece is the paid in full. The second part is, does that company request that it be deleted from the credit bureaus? Because a lot do and a lot don't. And so if they say they do, even better. That's one less step you have to take. Within 30 to 60 days, that collection will fall off the report and you'll see your score go up. It just depends. Everybody's credit is kind of like a fingerprint. There's no one size fits all, but I would say, you know, typically 30 to 50 points, you're going to see your score shoot up. So that is you know, the paid in full piece is huge. The trade line deletion, do they delete it from the credit reports, is huge. And if they don't, then as soon as you get that paid in full letter that shows you've paid your collection, you can go right into TransUnion, Equifax, and Experian, go to credit dispute. You upload your paid in full letter and they're going to remove that collection. And typically at the same time that we're disputing that collection, if it's not been deleted, you know, I typically recommend my clients put together a goodwill letter, which is just where you were when things went wrong, where you are now, and where you're trying to get to. Kind of a, you know, a brief story of three paragraphs of where you were, where you are, where you're trying to get to. So that somebody, when they read that, they're going to feel that you're trying to turn a corner, and they're going to empathize with you and hopefully delete some late payments as well. And whatever other negative reporting you're trying to dispute.
Are you saying attaching that with a dispute? Is that what you're saying? Attaching that letter?
Yeah, because if you're, you know, if you know you paid your, because if you paid that collection in full and it's showing as paid in full, it's going to fall off. They're going to have to delete it. So if you're going to go in there and go through the trouble of disputing items, you might as well go in there and dispute your late payments and just say, hey, I was 18. I didn't know what the heck I was doing. I didn't know credit existed. Or, hey, you know, I went through a hardship. I lost my job and I had to choose whether to pay the utility bill or to pay my car loan. And obviously I need power for my family. And so, you know, with that too, I also recommend if you've got, you know, if you went car shopping and you went to a dealership and they pulled your credit six times, you know, I know there's supposed to be some lenience with the agencies for not having that, you know, be super impactful to your credit. But I typically recommend people dispute those duplicate hard inquiries too that show up on the same day, because you're only going to move forward. You're not going to move further backward by just simply trying to dispute some items on your credit report. So right. Any gains are going to be huge.
Exactly. So like you said, you could stay where you're at, or you can be like, hey, let's try to throw these in hopes that it eliminates some of those, because that's what a lot of it is on that backside. It's the timing, it's the dispute process. Ryan and I have done that same thing, Jeremy, with you. Like when we talked to Jerry initially on this conversation, we're like, this is like great, because we're right down that same alley of what we got to do. But we see a lot of it. It's frustrating if that client has a lot of stuff on their negative stuff on their credit report. It multiplies that by 2, 3, 5, 7 times. It takes a little bit of time to do it.
Yeah. Well, and why not let the bankers that are willing to work with you remove that anxiety, right? Because I know a lot of people, they don't, like you said, you both have said, you don't necessarily know where to start. And so it's overwhelming. It's just like if I were going to try to, you know, close a mortgage. I mean, I'm not a mortgage banker, right? I'm not a broker. I don't know that process through and through. And so why not, you know, rely on the advisors rather than take on something that maybe you're not quite sure is going to go the way you want it to go.
What's your advice on someone who's maybe looking into hiring a credit repair company?
Don't do it. from my experience, they kind of draw it out. You know, at BMO, I can't speak for every single banker because there are certain limits for certain people, but I can speak for myself when I say that reach out to me if you've got questions about that. I mean, I've had so many people who tell me they pay, I will not name any companies, but you know, a couple $100 a month and it takes a year. Whereas there's never any guarantee. You know, I don't want to say go back to the one size fits all with collections. Repossessions are a little bit more difficult. Judgments are a little bit more difficult because that's when the attorneys are involved. But before you jump into anything, I would say reach out to a trusted advisor. My contact information is on the screen. You know, I'm an open book. I'm a transparent person. I'm never going to overpromise, or lead you astray. And if I don't have the answer, I'm not going to make one up. I'll tell you, I don't know, or I'll try to figure it out and get back to you. But, I have not seen people have good experiences with credit repair agencies. There might be, I'm sure there are good ones out there. I don't know of any personally. So, and I haven't had to, right? Because this is something I've been practicing for years. So,
right. Exactly.
What do you guys think about credit there? Hey,
so, well, that same philosophy, like we could probably give you that same name you were going to say that you didn't say, you know, because we know the same thing that we see it over and over, that there's some that really, that looks like that there, it takes them 12, 18 months. And on some people, like you said, each person's different. So it could on some, but some people, like you said, it only takes a few months, 3 to 6 to get them to turn around a little bit where they need to be at. And those are the ones we try to actually help. If we can help them, we always tell them, we'll help you and guide you. You can do this all on your own for free. But if you don't have time to do it, then you can go and hire somebody to run through the process, but it's going to cost.
Yep. And typically, if I've got somebody.
Go ahead. We got a little delay, I think.
Excuse me. Sorry. Oh, okay. I was going to say, you know, from my experience, I typically see results in 60 to 90 days. If I've got somebody who's all in and ready to get after it, and they've got the money to pay off the collections, and they're at home that later that evening putting together that goodwill letter, I mean, it can be done, you know, in less than 3 to 6 months. It can be done in 2 to 3 months. Again, it's just a matter of the pace that you're moving at. So my apologies. Back to you, sir.
No, you're fine. So we've been fortunate to meet some people in the industry that do credit repair that we feel do a pretty good job. Even with that said, the problem is a lot of these companies, the ones you're going to go Google credit repair, the ones that are going to show up, number one, number two, yeah, man, they just slow play it. They're going to charge monthly fees. They're going to charge an upfront fee. They're going to make all these promises to do all this work for you and have this major impact that people rarely see, and they rarely see it done quickly. So my advice would be, you know what, sometimes you got to kind of get in there and help yourself a little bit. There's things you can do on your own. Talking to somebody like Jeremy, Steve, and myself, just getting some tailored advice, right? Might do you a lot better off than just going and hiring a company and saying, hey, fix it.
Exactly. Hey, so it's like the stuff on that, like it goes down this whole thing, like that you hit on a little bit ago, Jeremy, when you were talking on that whole picture of the utilization that you got to work with the, you know, your balances on your credit cards and then the longevity of the payments and the chart that goes around, that it's a mix of everything that has to go together on that. That's that part that, like we talked about at the beginning. Unfortunately, that's not taught in high school, just the basic side of it. I think a lot of times if you can just go through that basic side, like what we've talked about in the last 20 minutes would be enough to give somebody a start out the door. Your thoughts?
Yeah, definitely. I mean, every client I would sit down with, it's, you know, I know you came in to do this and we're going to do it, but when was the last time somebody reviewed your credit with you or taught you all the little things? You may know some of them, but more often than not, there are so many pieces that, you know, are just not common knowledge. And so that was just part of the routine with every single person I come into contact with. I'll go out with friends and we'll be sitting at a Colts game. I'm trying to watch a game and they'll be asking me about credit. And it's like, all right, well, we could talk about this or we could talk about this after. But I mean, it's so important. You know, it's, you know, I mentioned it's kind of like being in good physical shape. It's also, you know, you think about credit like trust in the same capacity. You know, it can take years to build trust with somebody, and it can take years to build your credit. And you tell one lie or you make one bad decision and you can devastate all that hard work. And so it's so important to understand where things can go wrong before they go right. And that's what I teach people with bank products. It's like a product can really hurt you if you don't understand the way it works. But if you understand the way it works, it goes from being a product to a solution, and it can make your life easier, and it can open up the doors for your family, your friends. If you can spread that knowledge, it's massive. It's huge. I never realized I'd become such a credit nerd. But I love it. I mean, I just wish, you know, like we said, I wish it was something that was, there was a foundation taught before you get to the point where you can already, you know, start ruining it before you even understand that it exists.
Yeah, and you know, and you hit on that, and that's one of the things, like Ryan and I, with the whole thing with the show and tell series that we're doing now, that we did this years ago with the same thought of trying to just help educate people. So we've got that same thing where when we talk to clients, we've got a, we call it a credit crash course that we actually have. It's the same thing. We supply it to the client when we're talking to them to have them go to it. And it's got, I think once it got Ryan, 8 videos in the series. They're all short little clips talking about credit utilization and different tips that they can sort of go through and familiarize themselves, and they can do it right on their phone. And that's what people like with it. It's a little bit of a resource to help them out.
It's a lot of the questions that people would ask us, or it's a lot of the things that we explained over and over and over again. And we're like, you know what, let's just put together a quick little video course that just about anybody could watch in a matter of minutes and have a better understanding about how to build, you know, and maintain credit. And then I want to make sure that people know how to get a hold of your guys's, what do you call it? What's the name of your program?
Credit Builder.
Credit Builder.
Is that right?
How do they start that?
Credit Builder. Yeah.
Where do they go for that?
If you're interested, reach out to me. And depending where you're located, as for like geographically speaking, I'll set you up with a banker who can set an in-person appointment. But we've got about 40 branches throughout the Indianapolis and surrounding areas, as far north as Kokomo, as far south as Martinsville, and BMO, just finished an acquisition of Bank of the West now. So, we're going to be doubling our footprint in the United States and going to carry this program over to those new locations as well. But my information, I'm an open book. I'm accessible. I am leaving for vacation tomorrow to go ski in Salt Lake City for 6 days, which I'm very excited for.
There you go.
If you shoot me an email or if you call me, leave a voicemail. Don't just call and hang up, because then I won't be able to follow up with you.
That's good. That's awesome. Hey, that's been so much stuff on here, Jeremy. So I'd like to, I guess one thing, I know we're running on the time side of it, but Ryan, I'd love to have you back on just to like maybe just hit some of these other topics and dive in a little bit deeper, more specifically on something and pull up down the road. If that would work out great for you, we'd appreciate it.
Yeah, I'd love to. I've enjoyed chatting with you guys. I appreciate the opportunity. Shout out to Jerry Smith for connecting the three of us. It's my pleasure. I love that you guys are doing what you're doing. Looking out for our fellow person. I mean, life is short. Got to look out for the people around you. So that's why I love what I do and I continue to do it. So
it's been my pleasure. Thanks, Jeremy. If you guys liked what you saw today, just, share this. It's got a bunch of stuff in it. Like it, comment on it. If you got questions, reach out to Jeremy. He'll get you hooked up.
Thanks for being on, Jeremy. We appreciate you.
Yeah, thank you, gentlemen.
All right, so next week is our second community spotlight for 2023. We're going to be talking with Sherry Rail from Kokomo Urban Outreach. If you're not sure what this amazing community program is all about, you're going to want to be here for this one. See you next Tuesday at noon.